Thank you so much, Mr. Taylor, for helping me with math corners. Today, we're going to talk about graphing points. So I'm doing my IXL.com skills, and I found graphing points. This does not look like math, but it is, and it's a lot of fun. So you start off with the chart or graph. This looks like two normal lines. One on the bottom is called the x-axis, and the one on the left is called the y-axis. They meet on the bottom left at zero. Now you have this graph with x and y number lines, and you graph a point on the chart. Each one can be assigned a letter. So each point can be assigned a letter. So if I have point A, you can put it on the graph. But where? So you can find where that point is by the location on the number lines. First, you list the x-axis and location, and then you list the y-axis location. So, if you have point A on 2, 3, it would be 2 squares over to the right and 3 squares up from the bottom. Now, it is important that any other points on the graph have nothing to do with the others. So just because point C is also on the graph does not get in the way of point A. Now, sometimes they give you put the coordinates and you have to plot the point. So if you are told to put point K on 4, 2, you would first look on the x-axis and move 4 squares to the right, then look on the y-axis and move 2 squares up. Then mark your point on that location. Oh, and be sure to put a K next to the point. So Mr. Taylor, did you see... Okay. So Mr. Taylor, do you now know all about how to do graphing of points?
Yeah, I do now, thanks to you. And what's cool, Tiberius, is I'm actually studying... kind of for fun, some microeconomics, and all these graphing points are things that you have to use in microeconomics to display the supply and demand graphs.
Thank you so much, Mr. Taylor, for your help with math.
My pleasure.